डॉक्टर रविंद्र प्रसाद, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंडोलॉजी, पीआईयू काके रांची। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंसेक्ट इकोलॉजी, हिस्ट्री, एनवायरनमेंट एंड इट्स कंपोनेंट। एंड कंपोनेंट्स आर कंपोनेंट ऑफ इकोलॉजी आर इफेक्ट्स, एबायोटिक फैक्टर ऑफ इकोलॉजी एंड बायोटिक फैक्टर ऑफ इकोलॉजी। व्हाट इज इकोलॉजी? द टर्म इकोलॉजी इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ग्रीक वर्ड ओइकॉस, मीनिंग हाउस और होम, दैट इज ड्वेलिंग प्लेस ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म। दस लिटरल मीनिंग और द मीनिंग फ्रॉम द वर्ड इकोलॉजी मीन्स अ स्टडी ऑफ हाउस ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म। सो इकोलॉजी इज द साइंस ऑफ इंटर रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड देयर एनवायरनमेंट, इंक्लूडिंग बोथ फिजिकल एंड बायोटिक एनवायरनमेंट, एंड एम्फसाइजिंग इंटर स्पेसीज एंड इंट्रा स्पेसीज रिलेशंस। एंड दिस डिफिनेशन इज गिवन बाय अली 1949। सो सिंपल डिफिनेशन ऑफ इकोलॉजी इज द स्टडी ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म इन रिलेशन टू देयर एनवायरनमेंट। इन ब्रीफ इट इज कॉल्ड इकोलॉजी। एंड व्हेन वी विश टू डिफाइन इंसेक्ट इकोलॉजी, दैट मीन्स अ स्टडी ऑफ इंसेक्ट इन रिलेशन टू देयर एनवायरनमेंट इज नोन एज इंसेक्ट इकोलॉजी। हेयर वी विल स्टडी द इंटर एंड इंटर रिलेशन ऑफ बायोटिक एंड एबायोटिक फैक्टर्स ऑफ द एग्रोइकोलॉजिकल सिस्टम विथ द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच आर ड्वेलिंग इन दैट वेरी ऑर्गेनिज्म। हियर इंटर स्पेसी रिलेशनशिप एंड इंट्रा स्पेसी रिलेशनशिप will be also studied. The term ecology was coined by a German biologist, Ernst Haeckel, in as early as 1869. Ecology related terminology, you should know some important terminology which are used in ecological studies. So first, ecology is of two types. Basically, ecology are of two types, out ecology and sign ecology. What is out ecology? A study of an individual organism or individual species in relation to their environment is known as out ecology. A single species, a study of single species of organism and their relation with their environment, we will deal, and that study of ecological aspect is known as out ecology. Then the second one is sign ecology, study of groups of organism associated in a community in the same environment where the group of organism dwell is known as sign ecology. Next term is biome. What is biome? The grouping of communities that have similar structure, composed of ecosystem of a similar vegetation type or ecological type is known as biome. Habitat. What is habitat? Habitat is the place where organism lives. Habitat is a place where the organism dwell. So the place where the organism live is known as habitat of that very organism. What is population? Population denotes group of individuals of any kind of organism. Insect population are a group of individuals set in a frame that is limited in time and space. And next term is community. In the community, in the ecological sense, includes all the population of a given area. given set of environment. Ecosystem. What is ecosystem? Ecosystem or ecological system is the functioning together of community and in a living environment where continuous exchange of matter and energy takes place. Ecosystem or ecological system is the functioning together of community and in a living environment where continuous exchange of matter and energy takes place. Example of natural ecosystem are ponds, lakes, forest, etc. Biosphere. All the Earth's ecosystem function together on the sphere of the Earth where living organisms are there. We term it biosphere. Environment and component of environment. Now we will discuss about what is environment and what are the component of environment. What are the factors of environment? What are the elements of environment? Environment is a natural unit consisting of all plants, all animals, all microorganisms, and this component, that is plants, animals and microorganism, is known as biotic component of environment in an area. Functioning together with all the non-living factors of environment, and non-living factors of environment include a biotic factor, that is temperature, humidity, soil, etc. An environment comprises of two basic components, that is abiotic component and abiotic component. Abiotic component are also known as physical component. And physical factors such as temperature, wind, humidity, light, pesticides, soil and their types, are known as physical factors of the environment. Biological factors is also known as biotic factors. Biological component are also known as biotic component. It comprises the living part of environment, which includes association of a number of interrelated populations belonging to the different species in a common environment, such as other members of the same insect species, food sources, natural enemies including predators, parasites and diseases causing pathogens, and competitors, same organism, competition between the competitor may be of same species, competitors may be of different species. So other members of the same insect species, food sources, natural enemies, and predators, parasites and diseases, and competitors, other organisms that use same species or food sources are known as competitors. This is pictorial scene of abiotic and biotic component. In one side, abiotic components are there, that is temperature, wind, rain, light, pesticides, humidity, rainfall, sunshine hours, adaptive factors, these are abiotic factors which are essential component of our environment or ecosystem. And another side, biotic component, which includes other members of the same species, other members of the same species, organism or insect or any living organisms, then competitors. Competitor may be of the same species group or different species group. Then food sources. Competition, availability of food is also a guiding force of rooting force of ecosystem or ecological system. The natural enemies of the studies which are to be studied. Natural enemy includes predator, parasites and disease causing microorganisms. Environment of an insect population consists of evolutive factors. How these evolutive factors are going to play important role in the regulating their survival, abundance, existence. What are those factors? So first evolutive factor is temperature, particularly in case of insect. The bulk of insect dies on the temperature ranging from 40 to 60 degrees centigrade. And killing effect depends on the duration of high temperature or minimum temperature. Maximum or minimum temperature, then humidity, adult insect emerge earlier. In case of dry soil or litter, adult insect emerge earlier where this is humidity or moisture is less, humidity is low. Example, a worm or can move slower in wet soil. When humidity is high in the environment, then certain insect may breed faster and certain insect may breed slower. In case of aphid, at higher humidity their population buildup is high. And next is light. Some insects are more active during plenty of light, whereas some insects are more active when the situation is dark. The insects which are very active during the night in absence of light, those insects are known as nocturnal insects. And those insects which are very active during day's time, that is when the light is plenty, that are known as diurnal type of insect. So light point of view, we can categorize the insect into two groups, that is nocturnal insect and diurnal insect. Then medium. Medium means, what is the medium? Medium is soil. Type of soil also regulates the nature and abundance of insect and their survival rate. Agrotis epsilon, that is cutworm, are more abundantly found in case of heavy soil, clay soil, whereas termite are more abundant in light soil. And soil pH also affecting the prevalence of different insect species in different ways. For example, wireworm prefer soil with a pH of 4 to 5.5. Now come to biotic factors of environment, ecology or ecological system. Members of the same species, member of the other species, and nourishment food source. Biotic factor means member of the same species interact, then the interacting effect is known as homotypal effect, and the member of the different species interact to each other, then that type of effect of effect is known as heterotypal effects. Food source is also comes under poverty factor. Then anthropogenic factors, those factors which are created and influenced by human beings is known as anthropogenic factor. That means activities of human beings also affect the existence, survival, breeding of insect species, and these factors are known as anthropogenic factors. Then when as we know that any organism living in the environment, their population and abundance fluctuate depending upon the favorability of the environmental factors. And the natural tendency of a plant or animal population resulting from natural regulatory process in an undisturbed ecosystem to neither decline in numbers to extinction nor increase to indefinite density. That means in a certain set of environment that are favorable for the environment, in that set of environment the living organism fluctuates their population in a defined range, and that range under that favorable set of environment is known as balance of nature. That very organism, reproductive potential and body potential. What is reproductive potential of any organism or living being or insect? The ability of an insect to multiply in the given time in the absence of environmental resistance is known as body potential of the very insect or reproductive potential of the very insect. That means if there is no adverse effect of environment is there, in that case ability of an insect to multiply, the capacity of that very insect or that very organism to multiply in a given time period is known as biotic potential or reproductive potential in the absence of environmental resistance. I mean to say that environmental factors also able to resist against the existence, survival and multiplication of the organism, and the environmental factors may favor in the survival, existence, multiplication, breeding of the organism. But there is an imaginary domain where there is no environmental resistance against the insect is there. In that set of environment, the ability or capability of insect to multiply in the given time is known as reproductive and biotic potential of the insect or organism. And that is decided by initial population. If population is very few, then biotic potential will be also very few. If the fecundity, that is rate of egg laying, capacity of egg laying is low, in that case biotic potential will be low. If the length of development period is very low, then the biotic potential will be higher. Lower will be length of development period, higher will be the biotic potential. And higher will be length of development period of different size of the insect, reverse is the case. And 6S. 6S also regulates the reproductive abiotic potential of the organism or insect. Insect pests with high reproductive rate and low survival rate are called R strategists. Insect pests with high reproductive rate and low survival rate are called R strategists. Example, aphid. The second one is K strategists, which reproduce slowly but effectively, compete for environmental resources, and so their survival rate is very high. An example of X strategist is coddling moth of aphid. Environmental resistance. What is environmental resistance? The sum total of all factors of the environment that tends to reduce the rate of multiplication of an insect is known as environmental resistance. Sum total of all the factors in an environment. That is, all the factors means temperature, humidity, rainfall, soil type, wind velocity, and sum total of effect of all these factors, which tends to reduce the rate of multiplication of insect, is called environmental resistance. And abiotic factors include temperature, light, moisture, and water, due to humidity, air, and rainfall, soil, and their types. And biotic factors include food, other organism, competition, interspecific or intraspecific, natural enemies, predators, parasite, and pathogens. Abiotic factors are density independent. And abiotic factor include, when we discuss the temperature in some little way, in warm-blooded animals is known as homeothermic, and these animals maintain a constant body temperature within a certain narrow limits irrespective of the temperature variations in the external environment. These are also called as endothermic animals. And under this category, warm-blooded animals or homothermic animals or endothermic animals, organism, mammals are the best example. Insects are poikilothermic, and these are called cold-blooded animals. They do not have internal mechanism of temperature regulation, and therefore their body temperature varies with that of surroundings. These are also called ectothermic animals. And example of ectothermic or poikilothermic animal, best example is insects. Socio-homeothermic animals. Body temperature slightly above atmospheric temperature and are able to air condition their nests. A best example is honeybee, a special type of insect which are able to regulate their body, and they are able to make their nest air conditioned. Example is honeybee. Thermal constant. The total heat energy required to complete a certain stage of development in the life cycle or in the completion of physiological process of a species is constant. That constant is known as thermal constant. And hibernation. Hibernation and aestivation are two diapause stage of insect which are mainly regulated by extent of temperature. When temperature are very low, that is during winter season, temperature is low, in that case insect become inactive, goes in inactive stage or resting phase, and that stage of inactivity taking place in insect during winter is known as hibernation. That means a period of suspended activity in individual occurring during seasonal low temperature is known as hibernation, which takes place during winter, for example in Mexican beetle and other so many insects. Aestivation. Aestivation takes place during summer when temperature, atmospheric temperature is very high. And in that very high temperature aerological condition, some insect goes in their resting phase, lycose stage, and that is known as aestivation. The period of suspended activity of individual occurring during seasonal high temperature or in a dry weather is known as aestivation. Example is cotton boll worm and gram pod borer, that is Helicobacter nigra. Then moisture is also a regulated abiotic factor of the environment, which regulates the survival, breeding, multiplication of the insect. And due to moisture content of the environment, there are so many changes taking place in insect. For example, body pigments. Insects develop dark pigment in cooler region, which help to absorb more heat from sun for raising their body temperature. This aids in getting rid of excessive moisture from the body. We already know from the study of physics that dark color absorbs light, so we wear normally black color cloth during winter in order to save ourselves against the high temperature of the environment. Likewise, insects develop dark pigment in cooler areas when their temperature is low, which help them to absorb more heat from sun for raising body temperature, and this aids in getting rid of excessive moisture from the body. Integument. Well-developed integument and fused ascarides in beetles and weevils add in conserving body temperature moisture. Waxy coating of integument also saves from excessive evaporation. Some insects have waxy body, and waxy body prevents them from loss of moisture due to evaporation. So, well-developed integument and fused ascarides, particularly in beetle and weevils, help them to conserve the body moisture, and their body are waxy in nature, and that wax coating also help them to save from excessive evaporation in order to save from loss of moisture from their body. Winglessness, that means absence of wings. Grasshoppers and crickets in arid region have poorly developed wings, and some are wingless, by which the area of observation is reduced. That means wider will be the area of wings, higher will be the loss of moisture, and lower will be the area of wings, lower will be the loss of moisture. Pilosity. dense, that means pilosity is dense hairs on the body prevent evaporation. When the insect have dense hair on their body, that also helps them to prevent evaporation, and there is minimum loss of moisture in that case. Form of body: oval and compressed body of the some desert beetles protect them from hot winds. Oval shape and compressed body of the some desert beetles are the benefits for those insect which protect them from hot winds by reabsorption of water from products of excretion. Some insect may reabsorb water from products of products in environment due to humidity. This is also an important component of abiotic component of environment, and different species and their different mature stages have their own range. Humidity affects the speed of development, fecundity, color, etc. If the water content of the body is high, dry air accelerates the development. Locusts sexually mature quicker, and number of eggs laid are more at 70% relative humidity. Rainfall also plays an important role in the movement of swarms of dead locusts. Saturated condition of moisture is injurious for development of a spotted bollworm, that is Elias vitella. Rain reduces the emergence of most of the insect from the soil. Example is ant, termite, red-headed creeper, root grubs, beetle emerge out from the soil after repeatable rains. Wind is also important abiotic factor of environment, which affects the insect behavior, their survival, their breeding capacity, their multiplication, etc., their speed also. For example, recently locust emerges in so many areas of our country, and swarm of locust goes along the direction of winds. Wind means air currents that interferes with the feeding, mating, opposition. Wind acts in dispersal of insect. Aphid mites, that is aphid mite, also may have may take air currents as a spreading agent and disperse through wind. Helicobarba flies up to 90 km with aids of winds. If there is no wind, their flight capacity is less, and in a higher wind velocity, their flight rate will be multiplied and increased due to high speed of air currents. Biotic factors are density dependent factors, and in biotic factors, number one is food component. According to natural nutritional requirements, insects are categorized into omnivorous, carnivorous, herbivorous, polygophagous, monophagous, oligophagous, saprophagous. These terms are very important, so you should listen, you should learn with your great interest, so that you can remember these terms. These terms are very important for information point of view also, and knowledge point of view also. Omnivorous: the insect which feed on both plants and animals is known as omnivorous. An example are wasps and cockroaches. Wasps and cockroaches are the best example of omnivorous insect. Second one is carnivorous, which feed on other animal as a parasite and predators. Predator and parasite of insects such as ladybird beetle and mantids are best example of carnivorous insect. Herbivorous: the insect which feed on the living plants is known as herbivorous, that means all the those insects which are capable to feed upon our plant or cloud plant are known as herbivorous insect or herbivorous insect pest. So all the cloud pests are herbivorous in nature. Polyphagous insect which feeds on wide range of cultivated and wild plants, that means those insect which have the capability to feed upon various plants of various botanical families are known as polyphagous insect pests. Example are locust, grasshoppers, hairy caterpillars, termites, etc. Then monophagous pest. Mono means single. The insect pest which feed on a single species of plant is known as monophagous plant. Monophagous insect pest. Best example is yellow stem borer. Yellow stem borer is an insect which have only one host plant, that is rice. In absence of light, they can starve. Oligophagous insect. Those insect pests which feed on the plants of one botanical family, single botanical family, is known as oligophagous insect. For example, some insects are preferring the plants of cruciferous plants. Example is diamondback moth, mustard sawfly. These two insects only feed upon cruciferous plants, the plant belonging to cruciferi family. Some other groups of insect comes under saprophagous insect. They are also known as scavengers, which feed on the decaying plants and dead organic matter. The group of insect, category of insect, which are able to feed only on dead plants or dead organic matter is known as saprophagous plant, that is Drosophila flies, horse flies, ascorbic beetles, etc. Then beneficial association. There are so many associations in insect, some association.
Okay.
So what is association of insect? Association of insect, that means behavior of the insect in different ways in group is known as association of insect. An insect beneficial association means symbiosis, commensalism, mutualism. This association are positive, goes in positive direction. Positive activities, association in positive ways is known as positive association or beneficial association. That includes symbiosis, commensalism and mutualism. And symbiosis means interrelationship between organisms of different species which live in close union without harmful effect are known as symbiosis. The member organism, they live together without harming each other. Each member being known as symbiont. For example, pollinator insect. Pollinator insect are able to live within association of plants, and without harming the plant, they pollinate the insect and they get the pollens for their own benefit. In this association, there is no loss of plant, no loss of the insect. Example is association between pollinator insect and plant insect, plant. Commensalism, one insect is benefited by living on or inside another insect without injuring the other and is known as commensalism. Wall-forming insect. Wall-forming insect comes under commensalism. Ant and aphid live together without harming to each other. And this phenomena is known as commensalism. when the commensal uses its host as a means of transport, the phenomenon is known as phoresy. That means sometimes termite carries eggs of other insect also, and sometimes ants carries eggs of termite and acts as transport of for the egg of termite. This process is known as phoresy. Mutualism, when both symbionts are benefited by association, it is known as mutualism. That is, ants and aphid, association between ants and aphid also comes under commensalism, and it also comes under mutualism. Termite and flagellates, association between termites and flagellates comes under mutualism. Factor influencing population growth, competition. Competing with one another or with members of the another species for limited resources like food, mates, suitable sites for reproduction or population. Inter-specific competition. When members of the population of the same species compete for resources, we will call it inter-specific competition. Example is cannibalism in American bollworm, and cannibalism in later stage grub of chrysopid is a best example of inter-specific competition. Inter-specific competition, this is the competition occurring between members of two or more competing species with identical requirements, cannot coexist in the same place for a long time. For example, aphid and jayseed cannot survive on the same site for the longer time. The elimination of one species by another species as a result of interspecific competition has come to be known as competitive exclusion or principle or gauge principle. For example, when floor beetle, that is two species of floor beetle are there, Tribolium castaneum, Tribolium confusum, were grown in the same jar of floor, one species eliminates the other, and this is known as competitive exclusion principle or gauge principle. Then predator and parasite. Predatory insect are predators are free living organisms that feed on the other animals, their prey, devouring them completely and rapidly. And parasites and organism that is dependent for some essential metabolic factor on another throughout its life stages is known as parasite. Whereas parasitoid is another term, an insect parasite of an arthropod that is parasitic in its immature stages, killing the host in the process of development, and adults are free living. This is definition of parasitoid. So this is all about ecological studies. This is the all about the concept of insect ecology. So thank you all.